Pitch and catch. And you do that tonight, and we move on.
All right, I just talked to Coach. He insists on going with a simplified game plan for you tonight.
What do you think?
Well, his thinking is we keep it simple, you don't get overwhelmed, and then we rely on the defense to do their part.
Wait, hold on. This is a joke?
All right, look, Coach just wants to put him in the best position to succeed.
No, this ain't high school ball, man. All right, this is the semifinals. If we go out there and simplify, they're gonna destroy us. Come on, this is crazy, right? Right?
Agreed. Coach needs to wake up. I'm ready for this.
Man, forget about him, man.
Listen, I don't care how much you played, you're a leader on this team. Leaders, sometimes they have to do what's right, even if they don't like it.
Got it, Coach. I got you.
Yeah?
Outside, a surprise snowstorm in North Texas with temps in the 20s, but that has not dampened the spirits of the folks inside of AT&T Stadium here in Arlington as we get set for the first of our college football playoff semifinal matchups as it's the USC Trojans taking on the Oklahoma Sooners.
What's up, bro? Good luck tonight.
Thanks.
Hey, man, don't listen to the critics. You got all the talent in the world. Just go out there and put on a show.
Thanks. Means a lot.
All right, man. Hit me up when you get to the league.
Yeah.
For the right to play for a national championship next Monday night in Santa Clara, we are underway from Arlington in the national playoff semifinal. Fielded about a yard deep. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. A first collegiate snap forthcoming for him as the Sooners have it first and 10. They will let him throw here on the very first play. That one into the hands of Kane. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. Oklahoma, remember, so many years, this was a running football program with a wishbone offense. As you think about all the great running backs to come through Norman, but in recent memory, things have changed. Success has been found through the air, and they've been efficient this season. Top 10 in the country in completion percentage and total passing yards. Well, they're going to get about three here out of this first down run, and that'll bring up second and seven. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. Oklahoma, such a proud football tradition, seeking their eighth national title. They were winners three times way back in the 50s, back-to-back champs in the 70s, and then added titles in 85 and in the year 2000, but they haven't won it since. On second down now, Gold. He'll get about four as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. He'll look to throw. And an alley to run. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. A little costly there. You wipe out the first down. You also move further back.
No doubt about it. So you went from moving the sticks. To them staying in the same spot, except for that one guy carrying the yard marker, he moves back farther.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Second and two. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 11 yards there, first down. A good throw there, but boy, a tough situation for this offense, for this program, really. When you think about it, Marcus Washington, four-year starter, came in as a true freshman to lead this team. He's third all-time in passing yards in school history, second in touchdowns, twice an All-American, a Heisman finalist, all that stuff. Never missed a game in his college career, 53 starts, but now he sits and watches as his understudy for the last 4 years finally gets his shot in the leading role. On second down, Gold. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs. Here's first and 10 for the Sooners. Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. Quick slant caught by Streets. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Sooner touchdown. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Sooners have taken the early lead. So that drive, certainly a confidence builder for an inexperienced quarterback.
And a confidence builder for the coaching staff as well, because now they're seeing that they can work with what's out there. In addition, they feel good about the game plan that they set up in advance.
Now following the touchdown, the Sooners get ready to kick this off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
Here we go. 18, Gator.
On first down, Darby. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
That's going to go as a loss of 7, and it'll set them back for second down. Looking to throw on second down. Morse, quick hitter here, it's complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan.
And that's caught inside. Here's first and 10 for the Trojans. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
60 Pittsburgh.
On first and 10, Morse. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came in the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Now Morse, and his throw is incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
And he locates Walker, complete. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
On first down, Morse. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
They'll run it with irons. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. The second down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
So they need 6 yards here on third down. They're 2 for 2 on third down tries so far on this drive. To throw is Morse, and he will score. Touchdown, Southern Cal. A 7-yard touchdown grab as they are now on the board here in the first half. Now they'll line up to kick the extra point.
All drives that result in points hurt a defense, but when they are the sustained variety, play after play, and they just can't get off the field and stop them, that can be demoralizing.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Sooner offense back out, ready for their next possession. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. They run on first down as they're able to get this forward for about 4. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Second and 6. This one complete to Streets. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. When prepping for this semifinal matchup, we went back and saw all the tape on Isaiah Streets throughout the year. And no matter who you talk with around the game, they say Isaiah Streets, what's so impressive, his route running ability. So much discipline, so much precision on the cuts. Not only that, but you sit down with him and you find out what an impressive young man he is. For the amount of talent that he has and all the stars and accolades by his name, incredibly grounded, just a remarkable young man. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. He'll try and run it. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. On third down, Gold. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth. Oklahoma now with a first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket, and he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive gain. Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Now they go screen. It's complete. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. You know, you think back to what kind of parallels you can draw for what this young quarterback is trying to do, trying to lead a team to a national championship with so little experience. And the one name that I come back to, Cardale Jones at Ohio State back in the... And he'll take this into the end zone for a Sooner touchdown. A 2-yard touchdown grab. And his guys have taken the lead.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes the score 14-7. Now following the touchdown, the Sooners get ready to kick this off. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Ready, break. The SC offense about set to take over here. They trail a one-score deficit 14-7 as they come up first and 10. Moores gets set to pass, and that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. For USC, such a storied program. 11 times they've been crowned national champions, beginning with the earliest way back in 1928, all the way until their most recent title in 2004. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
On third down, Darby. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. A strong pickup of 11 keeps their drive alive.
Obviously an important run to avoid the three and out on your own side of the field.
Shows a lot of faith in that offensive unit, doesn't it? That you want to run the ball in that situation. Pick up the first down. Also helps out your defensive guys a little bit, too. Allows them to get at least one more series of downs in order to get some rest.
Here we go. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, get it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
Running it with Darby, and not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down.
Let go, defense. Let go, defense. And here we go.
To throw on second down. Morse and Walker has it, and he will score. Touchdown, Southern Cal. 23 yards for the touchdown as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game.
After nearly 30 minutes of football, that touchdown puts us in a position where if they make the extra point, we're right back to even before we start the second half.
Extra point right down the middle, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Out is the Oklahoma offense ready for their next drive. And Charles, so much of this offense the last few years centering around the combination of Marcus Washington and Isaiah Streets. Streets saying Washington's like a second brother to him. And, of course, many know the story. Isaiah's older brother, Ezekiel, tremendous athlete in his own right, but lost too soon to leukemia a year ago next week at the age of 20.
And that is really a gut-wrenching story, as you know. And you look back at their high school days right here in Texas, just outside of Houston. Zeke was the star quarterback, a four-year starter, 8,000 passing yards. Isaiah, a year younger, he was the receiver. The two of them told recruiters, you know we're a package deal, so if you're coming to get us, you're getting both of us. And Zeke actually recruited by both of these teams playing here tonight.
And the two had dreams of playing for a national championship together, and now Isaiah with a chance to fulfill at least part of that dream. Here's first and 10 for the Sooners. They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And he whips that one incomplete there. We come upon halftime in Arlington. Great ball game, 14 apiece.
Hey, kid. I just want to check in with you. How'd you feel about the first half?
Hey, let's do it in the second half, baby. Come on. I definitely could have played better. Got another half to go. Just got to get back there and get on the same page as these guys. Get back out and get after.
That's right. That's all you can do. Just make sure you relax. Second half's going to be fine.
The winner goes on, the loser goes home as we start the second half in this semifinal matchup from Arlington. This will be fielded at the 8. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some changeups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
He'll get 8 on the keeper there. It'll be second and a couple.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it. And while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Could be 4 down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. On the ground, it's Darby. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, Morse. And that is incomplete here. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
Now the throw here complete on the right sideline. And he will score. Touchdown, Southern Cal. As his guys are in for 6. As his guys are able to regain the lead.
I know we often laugh and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. So now following the USC touchdown, on is the kick team to send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Sooner offense back out, ready for their next possession. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point, but it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw here. And that will be incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. Fielded just inside the 20. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. USC gets set here, first and 10. Here's Darby on the carry. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 3rd and 10 now. Off play action, Morse. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And that goes as a gain of 37 on third down.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop it before you get a good head of steam going.
And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Right back to him on first down. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5. Here's Irons. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 1 yard, and it leads to a 3rd down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to exit.
And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. The fake field goal catches everyone by surprise. And the Trojans add on to their lead. And a special play there by the special teams. It's one thing to fake it. He ran it in for the score.
I think the special teams coach saw something on film in preparation for this game. Told the head coach, now's the time. He got the green light, and they worked it to perfection.
Point after, right down the middle. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So now following the USC touchdown, on is the kick team to send this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Out is the Oklahoma offense ready for their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Now a quick slant as the throw's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Now, meanwhile, here's a 2nd down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
The goal of anyone running a curl route is to make sure you try and get defenders on your back and shield them away from the football. But sometimes, even when you run a good route, the defense finds a way to knock it away.
He's got goal. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 15 yards through the air and a first down. So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Another strong gain on the last 2 plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays. Here are the Sooners now, 1st and goal. Running it with Gold. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on 1st down.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this 3rd and long play as we'll get a timeout. They'll drop to throw. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces 4th down. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Sooner touchdown. Isaiah Streets, his 2nd touchdown of the night, as his guys are back within a single score. Well, when we were setting up and going over our run-throughs early this afternoon, and I'm talking 6 hours before kickoff, we saw Isaiah Streets out there alone with just his young quarterback and center going through all sorts of different routes, making sure that they had everything ironed out, and it pays off there on the touchdown throw. And it looks like this one won't work out. Hands team able to secure the football.
Let's go, fellas.
Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Looking to throw. Morse looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Robbins, and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They pick up 12 on the play, and the chains move. Here's first and 10 for the Trojans. They'll run it now out of the gun. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he is in for a USC touchdown. 24 yards. And the Trojans add on to their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
The Sooner offense back out, ready for their next possession. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when
nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now they got to get to the line quickly. They're going to look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off with great anticipation. First week of the preseason, probably not the pass, the impression that the rookie wants to leave right there.
Yeah, no probably about it, because that's not what you want to do to try and impress your new coaching staff, try to impress your locker room, and most importantly, yourself. Probably spent all night last night saying, don't throw an interception early. Make sure you take care of the football. But now he's got it out of the way. Hopefully he can just settle in and move on.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Well, the Sooners' hopes of a national title derailed tonight here in snowy Arlington. And, of course, all the talk's going to be, how would this game have been different if Marcus Washington was at quarterback?
Let's get in here, man. Keep your head up. You're nothing to be ashamed of. I'm sorry, Zeke's not here. When I came to your mom's house 3 years ago, I promised to do everything I could to get us to a national championship. I didn't get you there. It's on me.
I let him down, Coach.
You didn't let anybody down.
Whew.
let him down.
Isaiah, you did everything in your power to keep your promise tonight. Zeke will be proud of you.
I just wanted it so bad.
I know, man. I know.
Hey, son. Just want to let you know, I'm proud of you.
Yeah. Yeah, I know.
Hey, I mean it. That was a gutsy performance out there tonight. And for what it's worth, I'm glad you stayed.
Thanks, Coach.
Hey, son. This doesn't have to be your last football game if you don't want it to be.
He's right, man. You're one heck of a player, man.
Football is my life, man. But you gotta stay grounded in what's important. So I got a little surprise for you.
Isaiah!
Em! Looking good, Emily? Ooh, and I'm loving this hat.
Thank you.
Oh! Absolutely. Is that magenta? Fuchsia? What color is that? Okay. Hey, I bet he'd probably be good at off the board, huh?
Yeah.
Look, Emily has the best games.
Okay. If you had a unicorn, would you want its mane to be purple or pink?
Well.
Well, these are both tough, but good options. I'm gonna do pink, no question. Definitely pink.
Pink, no question.
Come on.
No, look, you see, look, you don't pick from the options given, all right? The game is in the name, off the board. Now it's clear. Okay, look, if I had a unicorn, I'd have a mane that matches its horn. Silver.
Mm-hmm. I'd go with onyx.
Oh, yeah, told you she's a pro.
Hey, how's it going? Todd, I'm her dad.
Hi.
Can I talk to you for a second? Thanks. She's a little too shy to ask you. We know that you're going to be heading to the NFL draft soon, and Emily wanted to find out if you would dedicate a game to her sometime in your rookie season.
Of course, absolutely, anything.
Oh, anything. Well, actually, she wanted you to throw 3 touchdowns in that game.
3? Oh. I said 4.
She did say 4. Is that okay?
Well, 4 touchdowns is a lot. Yeah, but how can you turn down this face? Look at that. But I'll see what I can do.
Yes.
Don't worry. He'll do it.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's great to see you again.
Nice to see you too. It was nice to meet you, Emily.
You too.
All right.
The college football season's wrapped up and the draft is 2 months away. Today we kick off the NFL scouting combine. Over the next 7 days, more than 300 college prospects will run, jump, catch, and throw for NFL coaches and scouts. Schrager, who's your player to watch?
Guys, can I get weird for a minute?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get weird for a minute. You know that kid out of Oklahoma?
He played in one game.
He just carries himself in a certain way. I see Brady, I see Russell Wilson, I see that confidence. I would not bet against
him. Talk about it! Look, I care about you. You should bet against him. I want you to succeed. He's played in one game and he lost it!
Okay, fine. He lost the game. You act like you haven't held a nail before. But in that game, he showed off some serious arm talent. Mm. If he performs well at the combine, I guarantee you there's a GM out there cashing in a late seventh round pick for him.
Guess we'll see soon.
Yes, I hear you, and I've been hearing you for the last 15 minutes. I'm on top of it. How many times do you need to... Yes, I'm on top of it. I'm meeting with... I've got a few other guys to meet this week, and then... I know that there's a time restraint. I understand that.
Thanks for taking the time to meet me.
Yes. Well, I know what he wants. I understand what he wants. He's told me what he wants. You don't have to tell me what he wants as well, okay?
Okay.
Just, can you hold on for a second?
Okay, but
thank
I don't
you.
Have a long
no, just
time.
Be quiet. I take any of the other top quarterbacks available, and I get praise, and I get to keep my job. Hmm? I pick you, a player that barely even picked up a ball in college, and then I'm nuts. And the seat that I've got to sit on gets red hot. So why don't you tell me why you should even be on my radar?
When I found out I wasn't going to start in college, it became clear that I should transfer if I want to play at the next level. But I didn't. Because my word means something. And I'm proud of my decision to stick. And if I was running a team, I think I'd want players that were willing to compete.
Hey, I'm going to have to call you back.
Call me back, but...
Yes, I'll have to call you back.
Okay, I love you.
I love you too, Dad.
Bye.
Are you for real? You know, you and I have a mutual friend, Mr. Jack Ford. He and I served on the same staff in St. Louis. What do you think he would have to say about your ability to lead a locker room?
Look, I respect Coach Ford, but at the end of the day, the players are the ones that have to go on the field and execute. You don't have the confidence of the team. Game plan doesn't matter.
Jack had some concerns about your leadership. And now so do I. I really hope you can show us something today. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, you can settle up the...
Hand over your phone. I want to check your internet history.
You want me to give you my phone? Is it... That's just like normal procedure?
You bet it is. You just give anyone your phone? If someone asked for your playbook, would you give them that too?
No.
What? What?
You have something to hide? Look, son, this interview's about transparency.
I think I'm being quite transparent.
Not transparent enough.
You're on a mountain in Alaska on a bus going 100 miles an hour. Where are you sitting on the bus?
Bus in Alaska. I go front of the bus.
Not middle.
Nope.
Have you looked at the engine before you even got into the bus? Did you check the tire pressure?
I hired a professional mechanic to inspect every part of the bus, as he is more qualified than me, and I am aware of my strengths and weaknesses.
Are you being cute with me, son?
No.
You're not. Now give me a serious answer. Would you be in the front of the bus, the middle of the bus, or the back of the bus, or the passenger side of the bus?
I already answered the front of the bus.
Why?
Because if I can see where we're going, I can make sure. Well, okay, is that the wrong answer?
Funny how many eyes are on us right now, huh? Breaking us down, picking us apart. Every mistake amplified. But we got it though, right? At least I know I do.
Hey, I'm looking for your agent. I don't have an agent. Didn't have an agent. Les Moore, congratulations.
For what?
For getting an agent. Me. Boom.
I don't think. Have I met you before?
You're about to know me.
Quarterbacks, group four.
Looks like you're up to throw, kid. Go get him. Or should I say, go get him, client? You,
No, I'm good, man. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's good. Got a lot of people already. Full roster. Too full.
We'll be right back.
Thanks, man.
New York fans were very vocal about you this week on social media. How would you feel about playing for the Giants?
Well, I'm flattered by their interest. But honestly, I just want a shot. They give me a chance, I'll be ready to work.
Totally understand.
What do you feel is your biggest strength as an NFL quarterback?
Well, I've worked with the legendary Jack Forth, so reading a defense is in my DNA.
What do you say to the critics that think you aren't ready to play in the NFL?
Well, they're right. I have a lot of work to do, and I'm focused on getting better every day.
Let's say this all doesn't work out for you. What's your plan B?
No plan B for me.
It's a great answer.
It's very smart. Thank you.
Bavarian chocolate cake. Nice twist. That's my client. Smart. Let it go to voicemail. Build some anticipation. But if you answer it, you'll show that the teams can count on you. Answer it.
Hello?
Sorry, sir. We regret to...
Yeah.
What? What was it?
You're not getting an invite to the draft. Which is a good thing. I mean, just ask Brady, right? Hey, how's this? I know a tailor. And he can make it feel like you're there. What's your vibe?
I don't really have a vibe. Should get like a suit?
Suit? Huh, ma'am? You like a man in a nice suit?
Him? Yeah.
Yeah. Huh? Stamp of approval. First class stamp of approval for somebody who's not getting invited to the draft.
I don't even have a suit.
Looking forward to seeing tonight, Daniel Jeremiah. We waited forever last night for a running back to go, for a wide receiver to go. I don't think we'll have such a long wait tonight, and I think we're going to see a boatload of wide receivers, corners, and safeties on this day, too.
The second night and second round will begin with the Arizona Cardinals on the clock, and I will give them $20 if they choose a quarterback. Some of the reactions.
You are definitely going in the third round. Third round is your round. This is the round you want to be drafted in, huh? Mm. I mean, no one good ever came out of the third round.
Russell Wilson came out of the third round.
Never heard of him.
Well, he won a Super Bowl, Les.
And so will you, as a fourth rounder. It's over. It's over.
It's only the sixth round.
Every agent's dream, representing a seventh rounder. Guess as long as I just get my 30%.
Yes, yes, yes. Did you say 30%?
Couldn't have done better at the combine.
You know, I didn't ask you to be my agent.
Well, maybe I shouldn't have been. I had people lining up wanting me to represent them.
No, you didn't, actually. I don't even know if you're credited, man.
What? Put her on speaker.
Okay. Hello?
This is Vic Fangio, head coach of the Denver Broncos. We've had our eyes on you for a while. Hopefully you'll be ready to compete.
We will be!
Who is that?
Don't worry about it. Thank you so much, sir. I'll be there. I'll be ready to go. Thank you. Oh, yes! Oh.
Let's get some grilled cheese.
Baptist.
Let's start at the top, gentlemen. The Broncos. Mm-hmm. Draft winners, draft losers.
I'll go first on this one. I gave it some thought.
Okay.
And I'm actually going to say winners.
Okay. I'm not in love with some of their early picks.
I know, but I'm talking about a couple of their late rounders and one of them who is fascinating.
Mm. Trace, you're talking about that quarterback,
I'm just saying, bingo.
Bingo. He's intriguing, for sure. I think a little coaching, a little patience, I think he could be a strong backup.
Ooh. If he's in the right situation, the right system, he could compete for a starting gig.
Adams, he never saw the field in college. We're going to go on the field and start for an NFL team?
I know, it's just a hunch, I guess.
Like that.
All right. That's good.
Go on the hunch.
So where are we headed?
Oh, isn't it on the app?
That you?
Yeah.
You know, I wasn't gonna say anything because I'm a professional. But for what it's worth, I think you are the guy that's gonna turn things around here for our quarterback situation. You know, I played a little JUCO ball myself.
That's cool, man. That's cool.
Had the coach in here last week, and I was not impressed at all. I do a little JV coaching in my spare time, so I have a really good feel about the game. Should have told him one of my plays. He could have used it this Sunday.
You know, I actually haven't met him yet.
Coach Fangio? Guy's a defensive genius, or so they say. And that's all well and good, but our defense was fine last season. Our offense was the real problem. I don't know if you know much about our roster, but if you're smart, you'll get the ball to that Lindsay kid, the running back. He's averaged more than 5 yards a carry last year. Ooh, I love that dude. And hey, I get why Elway drafted the two of you, but honestly, I think you are the guy. And you tell Elway I said that, or I could give you my beeper and he could...
Thanks. I'll pass it along. Not really sure how much they'll listen to me, though. I'm just a rookie.
Had Chris Pratt in here last week. Good-looking guy. But I think if he fights a Raptor, the Raptor's gonna win. That's just me. That's just me. I don't care how many names he calls me. In fact, I actually did some... I do some archaeology on the side. And I found a T-Rex bone in Missouri once. I think it was a T-Rex bone. I was like, look at... Whoa!
Sorry about that.
Cool, cool, cool. Actually, I think you can just drop me off right up here, man.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Just right up front. Thank you.
This is the start of something beautiful, kid. And in this city, if you need anything, if you need alpacas, if you need emus, any type of livestock, home loan, or warranty, you call me.
You're the guy.
If you... I think we'll call.
This game, it's about legacy, kid. Achievement, exceeding expectations. Your college accolades, they're in the past. Your draft status, just a number. But your legacy, you start building that today. It's about the way you interact with teammates, coaches, opponents. It's about fearlessness, week in, week out, overcoming the onslaught of the league's top defenders, demonstrating leadership in everything you do, from how you play to what you wear. It's about laying a strong foundation in your rookie season, becoming the quarterback I always knew you were. But first, right now, it's about winning the starting job. Good luck out there, kid. I'll be the one to survive.
Start your week by installing your game plan.
Level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi on
me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched and I better get set in. Finish him.
Mess around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all.
In the end result, I'm better killing them all. Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
Designer sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down.
All right, get moving, man. I don't want to see anyone walking around. Winners do not walk. Let's see some hustle out there today. We got a big game this week.
When I speak, you listen, couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew, it wasn't you. I know it's true, cause you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ready ever go. Sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kinda made my stomach turn when I rung it up. Wait.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
Say about that performance today. We have high aspirations as a team. If we want to get there, we gotta raise our game. Because if we repeat what I saw out there today at our next practice, it is gonna be a very long season. We can do better. That's what we've been talking about.
This is the player card. Here you can see your strengths and weaknesses by looking at your archetype ratings. This is your development trait. Superstar and superstar X Factor players will progress faster over time. You can improve your development trait by being one of the top performers in the league at your position.
I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Bag up off me and watch it lose. Dog is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run or I can hit you with the pass. I can't be touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0, Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard, my team is legit. Madden 20, Snoop Dogg is...
see in New Orleans. Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden league. His team is off the hook and you don't really want none. But if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some. But you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Bag up off me and watch you lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm getting